The White House, the government, the Democrats, whoever you want to call it, is on that BS. First, let's watch this video I did 2 weeks ago or a week ago. Look at this, just a little clip.
So on the 28th, that's when we find out if we're in a recession. I honestly believe, since everybody in the world is expecting for them to say it's recession and everybody to go crazy, they're going to create a new term. New term. Say something completely different that we never heard before. And I think they're going to say we're in a growth recession. Heard me, Kevin, talk about it not too long ago. And a growth recession is we're still in a recession, technically, but we're still growing. We're just growing slowly. And they basically base everything on the job market.
Okay, so I did this on July 17th on my lives and just a lot of my videos. I've been telling people we are in a recession. You feel it. It's a recession, but it's something different. And since the government, the Democrats, the White House, whatever you want to call it, know what's happening, they're going to prep and try to cajole the narrative of it. And I just seen this today released by the White House yesterday. Shout out to me, Kevin. He used to be on that stuff, yo. So he did something to show me to look at it, right? It say Treasury Secretary Yellen say U.S. economy not in recession. Debunks misperceptions that it is exclusively based on GDP, points to historically strong labor markets and solid consumer spending. So in history, this is what you consider a recession. This is what we coined the term recession off of this data. But now we need to switch up the terms. What did I say in that video? Appearing on NBC's Meet the Press with Chuck Todd, Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen explained the state of the economy, including its historic strengths, efforts to bring down inflation and all that. As she explained, the technical and actual definition of a recession takes into account a broad range of data. This is not an economy that's in a recession. Todd replied, if the technical definition is 2 quarters of contraction, you are saying that's not a recession. Yellen said, that's not the technical definition. There is an organization called the National Bureau of Economic Research that looks at a broad range of data and deciding whether or not there is a recession. And most of the data that they look at right now continues to be strong. I would be amazed if they would declare this period to be a recession, even if it happens to have 2 quarters of negative growth. We have a very strong labor market. When you are creating almost 4,000 jobs a month, that is not a recession.
What you say?
I said, whoever threw that paper, your mom's a hoe.
What did I say that was going to do? Y'all think I think some people don't know nothing. I told people, and I even broke it down more verbatim in different videos, but since I post like 10 a day, I couldn't even find it. Let's first just go with the basics. Let's just do this. What is a recession? So let's just go to the definition. So recession is, this is the first definition that just popped up, a period of temporary economic decline during which trade and industrial activity are reduced, generally identified by the fall of GDP, gross domestic product, in 2 successful quarters. You can look at it however you slice it, however you want to do it. That's the term of a recession. Now, what I said, they was going to say something different. They was going to create a name. I use growth recession because I was educated about it. It's like, oh, yeah, we're in a recession technically. But in reality, we're not in a recession. People are still spending money. Look at the job market. The jobs is growing.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God.
They took my job.
Oh, man. Secretary Yellen also went further in depth, explaining that some economic slowdown is healthy right now with such a strong labor market. As the Federal Reserve address inflation, we transition to steady and sustainable growth and discuss the actions the Biden administration has been taking a lower price for some people. Well, look, the economy is slowing down. Last year, it grew rapidly about 5.5%, and that succeeded in putting people back to work who had lost their jobs during the pandemic. The labor market is now extremely strong, even during the last 3 months. And I don't need to read any more of this because we already know how this ends. But the main thing you need to realize is the data is going to show we're in a recession. That's why I've been telling people months ago, yo, we're in a recession. And I had a debate with somebody on Facebook. Man, we ain't in a recession. Man, he said we're in a recession. Like, bro, you can feel it. We're in a recession. By the time they claim it and say, okay, here go the data, we're in a recession. Well, we was in a recession back then. Those was those months. Oh my gosh, June was just such a terrible month. But July, this month right here, is called growth. So they're trying to basically, it's all political. Basically, Biden don't want a recession under his name. Man, hey, Biden, when we was in with you, we had a war, we had a recession, and he have the worst approval rating in like president history. So it looks very bad. So they like, oh, we was in a recession, but technically, and they just going to go around in circles and just try to confuse you and just keep on going off of the job market. What's your thoughts? Let me know in the comments.